Hello viewers, today I am going to start with a new series in which I am going to prepare for lectures. First lecture is on the writing fast and smart codes in MATLAB. So I am starting with some examples in which you can easily learn that how you can speed up your code using some following. You have to take some important things to be keeping in your mind before you start with your codes. So first important thing I am going to discuss with you that in the MATLAB, when you wish to see the time taken by your code, which is called executing time, we have to use this command. This is called TikTok command, and using this command I am just going to compare all the things which I have mentioned here in this slides. So in the today lecture I am just taken the four important things which drastically changes your coding time if you are work in the MATLAB. The first and the foremost, the important thing is the pre-allocation required. It means that if you forgot to pre-allocate some variables in your coding, if you know the already mentioned size of the variables, you have to pre-allocate the size to that variables. Like if you go with the examples, the first example is that pre-allocation in which I have taken example in which I start with this command clear all. It will clear all the earlier saved variables in the workspace. CLC clear your output command window screen. TikTok command is there, it will give you the time. So this code will start from A1, means you the first element of A will give you one value, and I have taken the first element of B is value 2, and the for loop is from 2 to 50,000, and you will see that in this for loop, since 1 is already there, and it will calculate A2. And once A2 is calculated, it will go to the third element, then its fourth element, and so on. It goes to 50,000 elements. So vector of 50,000 you will get from this code. So what is the difference without having the pre-allocation? Since in this the vector is constructed with size is 50,000, and you are not pre-allocating the size, you can see the difference in the timing. If you run this code, I have run it already, so you can see that the server is busy, this MATLAB server is busy, the MATLAB is taking time, so much time. It will give you 8.7 seconds depending upon your configuration of your PC or your personal laptop. So it takes 8.7 seconds to execute this code. So since this code is not very big, if you go for 50,000, you can see that the huge time it will take. Rather than doing this, if you pre-allocate the some values, like if you wish to allocate zeros column vectors, so or column or row vector, give the size of this and then you execute this, you can see that the huge time difference, it's only 0.1. You can see that it's approximately 50 times lesser than the earlier. So this is the major changes you can see. If you start with this 50,000 rather than you can take 5 lakh, you can see that with the 5 lakh elements in this, if you run it, it will took only 1.64 second. And if you remove this pre-allocation, like I am commenting this pre-allocation, if I run this, and you can see that it will took nearly I think more than 10 minutes. So I'll stop it. Reason being, you can test yourself. I'll quickly go to the next example in which I tell you that rather than using the normal earlier classical approach which you used in your C and Fortran program, you can use for the vector approach. And what is and the important thing is using the vector approach, the time is drastically reduced again. And using cell mode, you can execute the different cells in the MATLAB separately. just for example, I'll start with example 2. In this example, I am starting with the vector approach. Give the example of vector approach. Since I have taken a very simple example, you can start with the ClearAll or CLC. TikTok command is there. This is a vector x is equal to from 1 to with step size of 0.01 to 1000. And the classical approach that you start with the for loop and you can write this code. It will give you the for every x, it will give you the y. So this is the length of x. It means that length of x is nearly 1 lakh. So just plot it for this for loop. You can see that it's already busy and I'm waiting for the result. So only 1 lakh elements, which is not a very large data for this MATLAB. So it's executing. You can see that this output is parabola, that this is correct, and output time is 24 seconds. So this is okay with the time, with this is okay. But if you go with the vector approach means that your plot is this. I'm just closing this plot. And if you rather than doing using this for loop, if you do only write this dot cap 2, it means that in the vector approach you have to write dot cap dot multiply. These all symbols are like dot multiply. So dot divide, this all things you use to just use the vector approach. In this vector approach, this x is because you want the y in which each element will be square of the earlier value of x. So for this x, you can directly run this and you can get the plot of same plot with only 0.45 seconds. So you can see that vector approach is much better than earlier classical for loop approach. So you can use this approach in the MATLAB. Another thing is important thing that this is called the cell mode. You can see the cell here, just giving writing the 2% sign, you can construct the cell, and this cell means that you can independently execute all the section of this cell. This frame is now divided into 2 sections. You can just right click on this. There is a value called execute cell, or you can use the control enter. This command will give you just execute this thing, and separately you can execute this. This will help you to just partition your code, and whichever things you think is important, you can execute there. So you can just learn about the cell mode. This is a new thing in this MATLAB, which is not you can. Third thing is profile report. In the profile report, you can just see that if you have written any code, this command will help you to find out the place where the code will took a maximum time, and you can just either you can modify your code or you can change the inbuilt function or a choice is yours. You just have to modify the code so as to reduce the time. So I have taken a very little example. In this example is very small, just to show you that it contains inbuilt function gamma and another sine function. And examples, I just start with this profiler. Firstly, you can use profile on command, and you can execute this example. Profiler is on, so you can use profile report. So this total time is taken is about 0.1 second, and you can just enter on the example 3. You can see that the time is taken by this 8th line end, and in build this is almost the same. So this, in this function, you need not to be worried about this, because it will not execute any of this inbuilt commands. And the command is inbuilt, so it will take less than this time. But if your code is very big, you can see that it will give you the time to each and every step of this. since this code is very small, so you can't compare it, but you can go with your own code and see that it will give you the place where it took a maximum time. So last I am go with this matpool soft command available here. Since instead of using a for loop, if you are willing to use the for loop rather than the vector approach, so preferably you can use the pair for loop. I've chosen one example in which you can see that this is the matpool for pair loop command, in which I have taken 1 to 10 size of this, and eigen values are for some random function is used. If I run this cell, since this cell take using the for loop only this, and another cell I have using this pair for command, so able to use the vector approach, or you can't able to take the benefits of the vector approach, so you have to use the for loop. So in such cases I told you to preferably use pair for rather than for loop. So you can see that executing time is 35 seconds. Anyway, if I start with this cell in which the MATLAB pool is 2, because my laptop is i3 and it's containing only the 2 cores, so I can only use the MATLAB pool 2, or my MATLAB version is supporting only the 2 labs. So parallelly 2 work is, you can see that language here, starting the MATLAB pool using local configuration and connecting to 2 labs. Now the parallelly 2 person is working on this, it's just like the 2 labs is working on this same program, and finally it will give the output. You can see that only 23 seconds it will take. Comparatively it's less, but not very less, because actually it is a for loop, but 2 persons are using and then combining the data and finally gives you the output. Output will be the same. If your data is used, like if instead of this you are talking about the 100 times you are doing this, then you can see that it will give you the major difference. So thank you. So if you like this video, so please subscribe for the new updates. All the best. Thank you very much.